I did it, then I did it right. This ain't happened for me overnight. Bet against me, you gon' pay the price. Down to business, I ain't playing nice. So ahead of y'all, I'm out of sight. When you poppin', they don't wanna slice. Greed and envy, that's a part of life. Mediocre, that just won't suffice. Keep myself grounded, that's a piece of me that I won't let go. No matter what level I reach, I promise to hold it close. Ain't gotta tell me this hitting different, man, I already know. How are you claiming we had a baby, we ain't never spoke? I don't be out here with random women on the road. They want a DNA test to prove it, I'm like, here you go. I could've saved you a bunch of time and told you the results. Looking for hush money from me, you ain't gon' get it though. Historic, rain on my parade, I keep walking and ignore it. Just part of the game, yeah, it comes with the territory. It's just another day, man, I'm used to it downpouring. It's nothing. If I did it, then I did it right. This ain't happened for me overnight. Bet against me, you gon' pay the price. Down to business, I ain't playing nice. So ahead of y'all, I'm out of sight. When you poppin', they don't wanna slice. Introduction. Ooh. Style my own kid, no one touch it. Ooh. Became what they said I couldn't. Ooh. Mediocre, that won't cut it. Life is a gift, I wanna live it to the fullest while I can. Why would I not wanna know my days in this game are numbered? Might as well enjoy the few years that I do have left. Who knows when I'ma write my last verse. I've been to hell and back ever since that first EP came out with all I have on it. I've been giving all I have, wasn't really prepared for the pain I was gonna have to go through to get to the end result that I knew I wanted. Hope that would make an impact in rap. Has that been insane?
BA Sports coverage of the National Football League is in Uptown Charlotte, North Carolina at Bank of America Stadium. Today, we've got a Week 13 matchup for you here, as it'll be the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on the Carolina Panthers. The former Illini kicker Chase McLaughlin to get us started. And off we go from Uptown Charlotte. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Now problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay. Thank you.
Ready up.
On play action, Young. And he takes us beyond the 35. I guess no need to force it when you can do that instead. First down, 18-yard gain. Give a little extra credit there. His head was cool as the play broke down. Didn't force a throw, and in the end, got to show off his athleticism with a nice gain to bring up a new set of downs. On first and 10, Young. Going right side, he finds Slayton. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
Let's go! Ready, ready.
Young off the bootleg. And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. Yaya Diaby, he's the one who got in there. He gets the sack.
And that's their first sack of this game, but how about last week? Six sacks, great coverage downfield, which helped that pass rush. They are really working in sync right now.
On the double. Well,
they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21.
Red, yellow. Ready?
Here is Young. And connecting here with DJ Shark. This is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 42. A gain there of 21 yards. So for Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. They go play action. Young. That's once again complete to Shark. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. They go right back to him from 20 and a first. That early game script that they drew up is working pretty well here on this first drive. Already in field goal range, Charles knocking on the door of the red zone.
You know, Brandon, when we met with the coaching staff, they kind of predicted that they would come out firing like this. I think you and I were a little skeptical that it'd be this easy. But they certainly knew what they were doing in scouting, in preparation, and understanding what their team was capable of.
Hey, hey, blue, light blue.
And they just get the playoff. Now Young dancing to his left. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
The Panthers had 8-3 now. And they come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victories, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
Young's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw.
That swung out wide to Sanders.
And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 12-yard line. Give them 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Catch made by Slayton. Touchdown, Panthers! Darius Slayton, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers will jump on top with the game's first score here this afternoon. Point after, right down the middle. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
Now this will be returned from deep in the end zone.
And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him three more.
They'll start out here with the option left. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a hole. Give him three on the keeper there, and it is second down.
You look at this Carolina defense.
They really played well in that win last week against Miami.
One thing you always look for when you're evaluating a defense, how opportunistic are they? How many takeaways do they get? How about last week's game? The number was six. Phenomenal performance.
Snap will come from the 31 on second and seven. In motion left, Bateman. To throw on second down, Burton. And Cook has it, left side. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Now the first carry for Dalvin Cook. And he maneuvers up the middle for three, and it's second down. Well, this defense for the Panthers, they played really well in that win last week against Miami.
And one of the key things you always look for when you're evaluating a defense is how opportunistic are they? How many takeaways do they get per game? And how about last week's game? That number, six. Absolutely phenomenal performance. They were on top of their game right from the first snap.
Second and seven. Looking to throw, Burton, and complete, right side to Cook. A one-yard gain there following the three-yard pickup on first down.
You look at this Carolina defense.
They really played well in that win last week against Miami.
And it was the pass rush that really keyed their victory. Got to the quarterback six times for sacks and plenty of other turbulence in the pocket for him as well.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. On third down, Burton. He's got his target. That's complete. And he is going to have a box first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Solid opening drive so far, Charles. They move this football into field goal range, but you know that they want to cap this off with six and not three.
Absolutely. As one of the better coaches in the league always tells me, on offense, I want to throw body blows all game long and finish it with uppercuts. Well, here are the body blows right now. He's hoping one uppercut will take care of the end of this drive.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. First down, here's the run with Cook. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second quarter now, and it's Buccaneer football as they've got it with a first and 10. They run again on first down. Cook, and not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Second and 10. Back to throw. Burton. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
But it looked like he marched to the end zone. It's a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
It's been a pretty long drive. This will be play number 9, and they need 10 yards out of it on third. Looking to throw. Burton. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
That's a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
And his kick is right there. It's good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx it.
He will return this from deep in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the... the 22.
Ready.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And, Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left, only in November, but they would be a wild card team, and that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a two-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs. So they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. And Shark hauls it in. And he'll be taken down before they work it across midfield. A gain of 28 yards there and given the first down.
He's been a busy man in this first half. They've targeted him quite a bit, including both plays here to start this drive. And until that defense starts reacting a little better, they may just keep going back to him.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
One thing you always worry about when he breaks the pocket is he going to take off with it? That time, the pressure was starting to close in, and he's just got to throw this one away.
strike. Check strike. Mega.
The play fake. Now Young. Buying time to his left. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time.
Here we go.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10.
Drill green. Quad red.
Young will set to throw. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he goes down before getting this inside the 25. Give him 22 there on the third down conversion.
The uniform is short-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds him for the first down.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he'll get about five here as he'll take this down inside the 20-yard line.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Now second and five.
43 rail. Black shot. Green jack. Ready.
Young. Touchdown. Tommy Trimble from 19 yards away as his guys are able to extend their lead. Extra point right down the middle, and that pushes the lead up to 11. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. They trail now 14-3, an 11-point deficit as they start things out with a first and 10. Now, boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Back to throw. Burton. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
Ready?
Shotgun snap, and then the give to Sanders. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. We've got a 14-3 ball game with 2 minutes left in the opening half. From the 23, here's a second and 7. Now the Buccaneers go ahead and take another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
Let's go.
They'll come up second and 7.
Blue with Stryker. Fury, yellow. Hut,
hut. Off the play fake, Young. That's complete to Slayton. 9 yards the pick up there, and it's a first down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Yeah, that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Now they'll try to take advantage of that offsides call. Here's first and five. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. And it's picked up by the Buccaneers. A defensive-minded coach loves to bring the heat, brought the heat there, and it worked out.
And nowadays, all those defensive-minded coaches, for them, it's all about getting the football. I went into one facility, and as soon as you walked into the defensive room, there was a football, like on a spring, and each guy that walks in that plays has to act like he's knocking the ball free. They want those instincts created. They want them to think about that all the time, and that's what they try to preach.
Following the fumble recovery, Burton. He's got his man downfield. That's Bateman. And they work this well upfield across the 45. First down now, but that clock rolling.
And Bateman, and he'll go in motion right here.
On first and 10, Burton. The Panther rush too strong. They get there to take him down. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Looking to throw on second down. Burton eluding the pressure right. It's caught by Mike Evans. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 36. That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
To throw now on second and 10. Escaping the pressure right. His throw incomplete.
This defense is going to have to finish the job. There's still a second half that they have to play. But so far, an absolute total effort. They've disrupted the passing game, stressed the pocket for the quarterback. They forced him into errant throws. Everything they're doing has been executed well.
They'll look to throw again. Incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. A missed connection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they throw it. Now with the short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
So the defense are able to force their first turnover of the game, and then they add on to that by getting the field goal.
And you don't just want to take the ball away from your opponent, partner. You want to make them hurt as well. And if you don't score yourself on defense, turn it over to your offense and have them put points on the board.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And with an 8-point lead, probably not too much of an impetus to try and do too much here. Young looks to throw on first down. Got his man and pass, Jonathan Mingo.
Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Young. That one complete. He finds Sharp. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. So they'll get 8 out of that completion. And they'll be left with second and a couple.
Brings up second and 2.
Ready.
And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half.
Triple 38.
And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. And his kick is good. Just did tuck it into the bottom of that left corner. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. So this a 2-possession ball game as we get back underway, set for the third quarter. And the fair catch signaled for and taken, so they'll begin this third quarter from their 25-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter 3.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well, and they've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense, because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
To throw on 3rd down, Burton. And he will not be able to hang on to the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on 4th and 8. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Panthers are going to get it back in excellent field position.
Black Ultra. Black Blue. 6 Mega. Steel Black. Set.
Young off the play fake. Steps away to his left. And he
just gets rid of it.
Throws it away.
Elias moved there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Well, they certainly knew their challenge as this series began, and they got a stop on play number one. Goal now, get two more stops and limit the damage to a field goal.
Young to throw it. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. That puts him in excellent position, first and goal after a gain of 19.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
Sharks got it, left side. Only a yard on the completion, it's second and goal.
It's a gain of a yard. Brings up second and goal at the 7-yard line.
Ready. Blaster, stick.
To the air once more, Young. And a quick throw here, that's complete. That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a third and goal.
4 yards on the pickup. It's now third and goal.
Ready, ready.
Here is Young. And he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line. Call it a big loss of 10 there. And it's going to bring up a fourth and goal.
Third and goal, they decided to throw for it. But how about the play defensively? Couldn't find anyone open. Left him nowhere to go with the football. Had to absorb the sack.
Now here's the Panthers special teams unit to try a field goal for 3. And his kick is indeed good, and that will extend their lead even further.
So the lead grows here incrementally, but I think the way their defense is playing, you feel okay with just getting 3.
They've definitely been stout so far, but now that could all change, because if one guy gets loose for 70 yards, this is a different game. But as it stands, field goals are good. Just keep adding to that lead.
And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And last time, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. We'll see if they can pick themselves up off the mat and do better this go around.
Sometimes I have this vision of coaches writing notes to themselves before a game. And sometimes that note says, be aggressive, stay aggressive. Maybe that's what we saw in the last possession.
Yeah, they were very aggressive. This time, will it result in points? We'll find out. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Well, the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
And Bateman, he'll go in motion right here.
Out of the gun now on third down. That is caught. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down by about 3 yards or so as they wind up getting 7 there on third and 4. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Slot man moves right. On first down, Burton flushed out right. This is caught by Evans. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. And we are keeping a close eye on his catches, a really close eye now, because that's number 899 in his career. The next one will give him 900. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 41. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Flush to his right. And he'll just get rid of it.
His impatience has to be bubbling over, trying to find a way to get his team to the end zone for the first time. He did find a way to break contain and get outside to buy his receivers a little extra time, but the connection couldn't be made on that throw.
Back to throw again. And Cook has it, left side. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. The Bucs passing game looking good on this drive. It's a first down.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
Again, he'll drop to throw. This to the tight end, Kincaid. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Looking to throw. Burton. It's complete on the bubble screen. That's Cook. And he is going to lose yardage here. To throw on second down. Burton. The ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. To throw. Burton. And in for the Buccaneers touchdown. Rashawn Bateman. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Buccaneers are able to get a score back in the final stages of this third quarter. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25.
Okay.
West Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. And Young's throw there incomplete.
Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well. And every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10.
Claude Rand. Black shot. Ready.
On play action. Young. That's going to be caught downfield by Chark. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30. 33 yards at a time.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports.
set, hut. Hut, hut.
That's once again complete to Chark. So just 3 yards on the completion there. And that will bring up second down.
Brings up second and seven at the 38-yard line.
Here we go, set. Fight, 97. Green Jack. Yellow, go. Set, go.
Sanders here as they run out of the gun. And he'll get four here down to the 35-yard line.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Blue striking. Fury, yellow. Cut, cut.
Third and short yardage, Young. And that is incomplete.
Coverage was awfully tight there on third down. They actually closed off all the passing lanes, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
And his kick is good. That kick, by the way, Charles, a career long.
Well, we did watch him in pregame, and he hit from this distance, so not a surprise. But there still is something exciting about it, carrying it over from practice and pregame to actually doing it in live action.
And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a two-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
And Bateman, and he'll go in motion right here. And he'll get an opportunity with it on the touch pass. Oh, and a great read by the secondary. They come up to stop that touch pass before it can even get back to the line. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield of man coverage and make up ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays just like that one we saw there.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Bucks try it on fourth down, but come up empty. And now the football's going to go over, already being placed at the 15-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Now Young. Over the middle, hauled in by Chark. So 5 yards here, five on the play, and it'll be second down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Striker, 3-3, ready.
A quick throw complete to Chark. And he gets halfway home from the 10 to the 5 on a pickup of 5. The offense on third down tonight, just 1 for 3 thus far. They're looking at third and a few inches.
22 needle. Rail, yellow. set.
They go play action. Young. Touchdown, Panthers. DJ Chark, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Panthers are closing in on a third straight win as they widen the gap further here in the fourth quarter. The extra point splits the uprights, and that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. The Carolina kick team is out there ready to go, and they kick this one away. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. Remember, they have won 3 straight, but getting to 4 straight does not appear to be in the cards as they are in a big fourth quarter hold. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 40 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Being chased out left. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And complete, right side to Cook. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. First down Tampa Bay there, a gain of 13.
A 3-score game here late. You can probably rule out the comeback, but certainly some kind of a moral victory to be had if they can get a few more points to close things out. And to that end, a nice pass play there to push things downfield.
Yeah, and we know in this league, a loss is a loss, and no one wants anything to count as a moral victory or, boy, something that feels a little bit cheap. But if they trim that lead down to just 2 scores, that's still a benefit to this squad.
They'll look to throw again. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line.
Dropped for a loss of 7 by multiple defenders.
Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Operating from the gun, Burton. That is caught, Rashad Bateman. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 16. 23 yards the pickup there.
Well, those are the types of plays they probably wish they had made more of in the first 3 quarters. And this deficit going to be tough to overcome here in the fourth. But a nice first down and a pickup on that throw.
And this is where, as coaches, you're looking for effort and execution, even though the scoreboard is going against you. You want to find out who's going to fight, who's going to scrap, who's going to keep their heads up and continue to play.
Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
Touchdown, Mike Evans. With a milestone, career touchdown number 100, joining Curtis Martin and Franco Harris at the century mark as he continues to climb the all-time list.
And the Bucs have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth.
Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good, and the lead is trimmed down to 10. And it looks like the Panthers hands team does its job. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none.
Ready?
Young here to throw. Forced out to his left. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
And once he escaped the pocket there, he tried to keep those eyes downfield, but nothing was materializing. So it makes a smart move and gets that to the sideline.
Eat old blue. Smash, red.
Young. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
On the ready.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Now Young. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now Young going to move him around. Now a play fake here on first down. Shark's got it, left side. And he will have a Panther first down. And it is celebration time on that sideline, and they've earned it. Young to throw. Once again, here's Chark. And one of the whistles for a timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal.
Black shot. Green jack. Ready?
And Young's going to throw it here. He's got it for the Panther touchdown. DJ Chark. His second touchdown of the game, giving him 12 on the season. And the Panthers are closing in on a ninth victory on the year as they extend their lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped it to 23. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you're going to go to the film, find out what the game is really lost. But this is not a situation now where you're going to make up for anything.
We'll see what they do here. The higher scoring game, Charles, than we typically see in the National Football League.